Okay, we will take this first problem. Four masses A, B, C, D are attached to a shaft and revolve in the same plane. The masses are 12 kg, 10 kg, 18 kg, 15 kg respectively. And their radii of rotations are 40 mm, 50 mm, 60 mm, and 30 mm. So, and the angular position of the masses B, C, D are 60 degree, 135 degree, and 270 degree from the mass A. Okay. Find the magnitude and position of balancing mass at a radius of 100 mm. Okay. See here, we have the four masses. Okay. We have the four masses. So mass A, B, C, D, weight of A is 12 kg and radius of the mass is 40 mm. Similarly, B is 10 kg, radius is 50 mm, C is 18 kg, radius is 60 mm, and D is 15 kg and radius is 30 mm. Okay, then and angular positions are B, C, D. Angular positions of B, C, D are 60 degree, 135 degree, and 270 degree from mass A. Means we will take mass A is the reference. From mass A, mass B is 60 degree, and mass C is 135 degree, and mass D is 270 degree. Okay. Now we have to find out the magnitude and position of the balancing mass. So the radius of the balancing mass is 100 mm. So we need to find out mass as well as angle. Okay, radius he has given 100 mm. Okay, so now we will start the problem. Okay, so now are you able to see this now? Separate another screen.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now. So this mass A is ABCD, okay, mass ABCD, and so first we will write the table then. First, mass name, mass name, then
angle, sir.
Yeah, I will write mass. Okay, here we will write serial number. That means that mass name ABC, this is the mass in terms of kg. Okay, then radius. Okay, so I will take in R, this is M. Okay, it is in terms of meter, we will take in meter, this is in kg. Next is we will take M into R. Okay, this is also centrifugal force divided by omega square. Okay, that means M into R. So centrifugal force is equal to MR omega square, right? So just we are considering M into R. Okay, then angle. This is theta. Okay, now this is the table. So I will write first A, B, C, and D. These are the A, B, C, D. The masses are 12, 10, 18, 15. Okay. 12, 10, 18, 15. Radius are 40 mm, 50, 60, 30. Means 0.04, 0.05. This is 0.06, it is 0.03. Next, you multiply this one. So multiply with M into R. Okay, so M into R, this is equal to, this is, it will becomes 0.48. This is in terms of kg meter. Okay, na? So this is 0.48. This is 0.5. It is 1.08. And this one is 0.45. Next, angle. See, in this problem he has given, angle is BCD, 60, 135, 270 from mass A. Okay, so means from mass A means this is reference. Mass A is the reference. Mass A is reference, so this angle is 0. Angle is 0. Then B is 60 degree. Then C is 135 degree. And D is 270 degree. Okay, so now this is the first step we need to do. Then we need to draw the configuration diagram. Okay. So how we are going to draw the configuration diagram? So to show the position of the position and mass of the balancing mass, so we need to draw the configuration diagram. So what is the configuration diagram? Just very simple. You take one point from here. So we are going to take the mass A is the reference. So here not necessary to use the scale. Only you can maintain the angle. That's enough. Otherwise, if you want, you can use the scale also. Scale for the radius. Okay. This is 40 mm, right? You draw the 40 mm line. Okay. Or you draw the 40 mm line. Then this is mass A. Okay, na? So now from mass B is 60 degree from mass A. 60 degree from mass A. So you measure the angle. You measure the angle. You draw the 60 degree line. So this is 50 mm is there. So even if you are not use that radius, no problem. But you have to use the angle properly. This is 60 degree. Okay, na? This is M, P, M, A. Okay. Next, mass C is 135 from the mass A. So, from 135, from here. So, 90 plus 45. Okay. So, you will get this is C, M, C. Okay, this angle is 135 degree. Then another one is, this is 270 degree from A. So you will get exactly vertically downward. This is D, mass D. Okay, this angle is 270 degree. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, can you take down this one?
Yes, sir.
Okay, first note down this one, then I will continue.
So can you project the question first?
Yeah. Once you finish the problem, you'll let me know. I will put into the answer. Okay. So now next we'll move to the couple polygon and forced polygon concept. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Just okay. So there are the two concepts. One is force polygon and another one is the couple polygon. Okay. So before going to the draw the either force polygon or couple polygon, we should know what is the couple. There will be the two forces. Okay, there will be the two forces will act in opposite direction in one link. So for example, if it is the link, there will be one force and there will be the another force. So we are going to consider this distance also, right? That we are going to consider the couple. Okay, so force means only one force. Here the distance between this distance between the two forces also will come into the picture, either in opposite direction or in the same direction. Okay, so this force F1, F2 and this radius all will come into the picture. So what we can do, couple for this particular position, we are going to consider F1 into R. So where this will come into the picture now? Where this will come into the picture? If forces are in different planes, now this is in the same plane. He has not mentioned any distance from the one mass to another mass. He has given only angular position. Are you following? Okay, now he has given only angular position. So all the masses are in the same plane. So there will be no couple. Where the couple will comes into the picture? When the masses are in different planes. So when you are analyzing the force by considering the couple, what we can say that couple or inertia, we are going to call that as the dynamic analysis. Okay, na? So here, if you are analyzing the force with respect to only angular position and force, position and force, we are going to consider that as the static force analysis. Okay. So here also for balancing of rotating mass using static balancing. When come to the dynamic balancing, the forces will be in the different planes. Okay, so if in case this is the shaft, okay, so here there will be one force here, there will be another force here, there will be one more force like that. Okay, so to balance these three forces, we are going to use one balancing mass. That concept we are going to call as the dynamic balancing of dynamic masses. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now what type of balancing we can use in this problem? What type of balancing is suitable for this problem?
Static
balancing. Thing is, there is no distance between the each plane, all the forces in the same plane. So only we have the M into R. Okay, so we are going to draw these forces. Okay, we are going to draw these forces using graphical method. We can draw that one. So now, how we are going to draw the force polygon? So first you take the force polygon. Okay. Now you consider scale. So here force polygon means we need to draw the diagram for M into R values. Mass into radius values we need to draw. Scale we can consider 1 kg meter sorry 0.1 kg meter I can use 1 mm, so it will become 1 mm. Scale is equal to 0.01 kg meter. So it can just simply I will write here for the for your reference purpose. So it may become 48 mm. Okay, so it will 50 mm. This is 108 mm. This is 45 mm. Okay na? So we got according to the scale what we got. Okay, 45 mm. So now, so we need to draw the force polygon. Okay, so first is the mass here. 48 mm for 0.48, 48 mm, 0 degree angle. Okay, use the scale, draw 45 mm horizontal line. 45 mm horizontal line. Okay, na? This is 0.48. Okay, now. So
Yes, sir.
now the second position is, this second position is 60 degree, means this angle. You can draw parallel to this line, or you can measure the 60 degree. Okay, you draw the parallel to this line 50 mm. So you'll get, this is 0.5. kg meter. So next we have the another line. This is parallel to this line you have to draw, that is 108 mm. Okay, you draw okay, so this is just approximately I am drawing, you have to use scale. So this is 1.08 kg meter. So next one is, this is the 45 mm vertically downward. Okay, from here to, you have to draw vertical downward line for 45 mm. Okay, maybe you will get like this. Point 4.5. So now from this last point to first point, you draw the line. Okay, so you will get like this. If you are use the scale, you will get for this angle. Okay.
So will that be a straight line?
Yeah, straight line only.
Okay.
Okay, by I am using freehand now, so you are getting like, but actually it will come, angle will not come exact vertical, it will come like this. So this is actually, it will give the balancing mass m into r. Okay, so you measure this distance. You measure this distance. Okay. So by measuring that distance, you are going to get the m into r, and you know the r value, radius he has given 100 mm. Okay. So you can divide that into the r, you will get the mass. And by drawing the line here by parallel to this line, you draw the line parallel to here. You have to draw parallel line of this one. Okay, so this will give the balancing mass m. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then do it now. How much will get?
The 60-degree angle from right side.
Yeah.
Okay.
Actually, we are going to see, we are going to measure from anti-clockwise direction. Always the standard way to measure the angle is from here, you have to start and you have to measure with anti-clockwise. So this is MB. So you have, why we are taking this line means this parallel to this one. Okay, actually the force will act towards outside, the centrifugal force. All the forces will act outside. Okay, now?
Yes, sir.
From that reason, we have started and we have drawn like this. Just you have to use parallel line to this line.
Okay.
So after drawing that 0.45, is this a bit connected to the first one, sir?
Yeah. So I will draw like this. So I will give the point like this. This is 0.1, 0.2. This is 0.1, this is 0.2, 3, 4, then 5. You have to join from 5 to 1. This is for your reference, I given the number. Okay, now? Join 5 to 1, then you draw that 5-1 line parallel to this 5-1 line here. This will give the mass, balancing mass. And it will close the
60-degree polygon.
76 mm. So you convert that. 1 mm is equal to 0.1 kg, 0.01 kg meter. So what is the value you are going to get? Okay, so according to you, you got
0.76 kgm.
Okay. You got 76 mm. Huh? So yes. After converting that, you got m into r is equal to 0.76 kg meter. Then, so here in this problem he has given R value. What is the R value? R is equal to
100
mm, that is equal to 0.1 meter. So what is the mass is equal to? M is equal to 0.76 divided by 0.1. So that is how much? 7.6 kg. Okay. So now add, you find out the angular position of this mass here. Okay. You find out this angular position of this mass. So how much you will get? Theta, I will write theta m. Theta m is equal to
72 degrees to angle.
How much?
272
degrees. Okay. Have you got these answers?
1 minute.
Okay, fine.
So how do we get theta m?
To measure this from this line, you measure the angle. That's it. Okay, with respect to A, you measure the angle. So you get 272. So we got magnitude and position of the balancing mass. Is it clear?
So how do we get that line? How do we draw that?
This line, you draw parallel to this 5-1 line here.
Okay,
you will get some inclination, right? You draw parallel to this line. A 5-1 parallel to 5-1 line you draw here. Okay. So we'll go to the next problem.
Yes, sir.
Okay, not on the next problem. This is the problem. A shaft carries three masses A, B, C. Okay, planes B, C are 60 mm, 120 mm from the mass A. Okay, B and C are 50 kg, 40. A, B, C are 50 kg, 40 kg and 60 kg respectively at the radius of 2.5 cm. The angular position of mass B and mass C with A is 90 degree to 10 degree respectively. Find the unbalanced force and couple. Also find the location, position and magnitude of balancing mass required at 10 cm radius in the plane L and M midway between A, B, A and B and B and C. Okay, now first note down this problem. I will explain.
Done, sir.
Okay. So now, So from the problem, we know that we have three masses. Okay. So with three planes, because these are in the different planes. Okay. So the shaft carries three masses A, B, C. Plane B, plane C are 60 and 120 mm from plane A, means three planes. Okay. So first one is, I will write plane or serial number. Okay. Then mass, then radius. So mass is m in kg, r in meter, then m into r, kg, meter, then we need to write couple. So that means m into r into l. Okay, so before that we need to write one more l here. Okay, that is distance between the planes. Okay, so last one is angle theta. Okay, so we have three masses A, B, C. Okay, the mass of the A, B, C is 50, 40, 60. Okay, na? So here in this problem he has given kg respectively at radius 2.5 centimeter, means he has given constant radius. So this is 2.5 centimeter means 0.025 meter. So similarly this is also 0.025, this is 0.025. Then we need to write m into r, that is this will become 1.25, then this is 1, then this is 1.5. okay, then distance between the planes, reference planes are, see here he has given the angular position and here he has given shaft carries three masses A, B, C. Planes B and C are 60 centimeter and 120 centimeter from A. Okay, so from A means I will take A as the reference plane, 0. Then from A, B is, from A I will take 0. Then from A, B is 60 centimeter and C is 120 centimeter. So I will write 0.6, 1.2. This is in terms of meter. Okay. Is it clear? So next, couple means m into r into l. So it will become 0. Then it will become 0.6 and this is 1.8. The angular positions are, this is 0 and this is 90 degree. Here we know that 90 degree and 210 degree. Okay, note down this table. Is it clear? Any doubt?
Yes, sir.
Okay, note down that. ಎಷ್ಟು ಲೆಕ್ಕ ಹಾಕ್ಸಿದ್ರ ಎಷ್ಟು ಹಾಕ್ತೀರಾ? ಈಗ ಹೋಗಿರಮ್ಮ, ನಾನು ವೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಲ್ಲ, ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಆಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದೆ. ಹ್ಞೂ, ಈಗ ಹೋಗಿರಮ್ಮ, ಇವಾಗ 2-3 ದಿನ. ಫಿನಿಶ್ಡಾ?
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್.
ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ನೌ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೇಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡ್ರಾ ದ ಟೂ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಗರೇಷನ್ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ವಿತ್ ರೆಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಪ್ಲೇನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಶಾಫ್ಟ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಶಾಫ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ವಿತ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ಎ, ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ 60 mm ಅಂಡ್ ಅನದರ್ ವೇಸ್ 120 mm. ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ರೈಟ್ ಎ, ದೆನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್ 60, ದೆನ್ ಅನದರ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ 120. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಬಿ ಸಿ. ಓಕೆನಾ? ಸೊ this is 60 cm and another one is 60 cm or 120 cm. Okay, this is plane position. Okay, position of planes. And second one is angular position of masses. Okay, so the one is A is the reference mass, so we will put into the zero. Okay, this is A. B is 90 degree. And C is 210 degree. Okay, na? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, this is configuration diagram. Now, which one we can draw here first? So now, according to the problem, he has given to find the unbalanced force and couple. Also, find the position and magnitude of balancing mass required at 10 centimeter radius in planes. L and M, midway between A and B, and B and C. So what it indicates?
No idea.
No idea. Okay. So here, thing is, we need to find out the position and magnitude of balancing mass, okay, and couple. Couple means, so here what we got this right, means distance also we need to find to place the couple. Is it clear? To place the couple, we need the distance. Okay, where we are going to fix the one is, see, approximately what you may get, you may get some position of the mass. Okay, some position of the mass you may get, and also here, what is the position of plane? That indicates the couple. Actually, last sentence is he has given. He has given also find the position and magnitude of balancing mass required at 10 centimeter radius in the planes L and M midway between A and B and B and C. So means in between here and here. So where we can place. Okay. So for I will go to the problem, then you will get the idea. So first, what we can draw here? If you want to draw the force polygon, okay, we know the three forces, right? M into R 1.25, we know the direction is horizontal. Then another one is vertical. Another one is vertical, that is one. Then one more, next one is the, we have the 210 degree angle, that is 1.5 kg meter. After that, so joining of last point to the first point, you are going to get the unbalanced force. Okay, so first, once you got the unbalanced force, what we can, so you will, in this case, you will get M into R, you will get, then by using MR, so in couple polygon, directly you are going to get MRL. Okay, so by considering that, we can find out the position. Okay, so for that, first we will draw the couple polygon or force polygon. You can draw any one. Okay, so I will start with the force polygon. I will start with the force polygon. Okay. Scale 1 mm is equal to what we can take for this one, 1.25. At least you required, if I used 1 kg, 0.1 kg, you will get 12.5 mm. So that is also 0.05 kg meter I will take. So according to that, what is the length of this one? 1.25 divided by 0.05, you will get 25 mm, correct? This is 20 mm, this is 30 mm. Okay, na?
Sir, in the above position of planes, you have taken it as 60 centimeter.
Yeah, that is 0.6, 1.2.
So it is 120 centimeter only, sir. So we should draw it according to proper scale.
No, not necessary, not necessary. Here, see these two, here it is not necessary to use scale because you can place anywhere and you can give the values. That's enough because that graphical representation, just we require graphical representation only. It won't give any answers. Second thing, even come to the angular position of the mass, angles must be correct. In case of length also, if you are not use the scale, no problem. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir. Yes,
if
sir.
If you are not use the scale for length of this, this is the RA. This is RA. then this is RB and this is RC. If you are not use the scale for RA, RB, RC, no problem. But you have to use the proper angle for this one and this one, 90 degree and 210 degree. Okay, na? So yes. now for these values, you will get this is 25 mm, this is 30 mm. This is for your reference, I am writing. Okay, this is, sorry, not this one, not here. This is 25 mm, this is 20 mm, and this is 30 mm. This is for your reference, I am writing to draw the force polling. So first is 120 for 1.25, that is linear, exactly horizontal. You draw the line for couple polygon. Okay, this is this force. Okay, this force I am writing, this A, mass A I am writing here. Okay. MA RA value. Okay, so I got two lines. Okay, just I'll scratch it. Okay, I'll start here. So this is MARA, or you can write the value of 1.25. Then we know that is the vertical line. Okay, 20 mm vertical line. This is 1.00. Okay, then we have the angular position of this one. Use the parallel line to this line. Okay, you will get okay, na? Then you join the last point to first point. Okay. So you measure the distance between this line. This is actually one point five, that value. So you measure this one. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 to 1, you measure the distance. That will give the, this 4 to 1 gives the value of M into R. Okay, na? That will give the M into R value. You measure that value. Do it.
So is it 0.4?
Sorry?
0.4.
0.4. Actually, I don't have the
5 mm.
How much?
5 mm, sir.
5 mm.
Yes, sir. So
5 mm divided by 0.05. Sorry.
We multiply.
Into 0.05. So you'll get 0.25. Have you got the 0.25 value? Okay, this M into R is equal to 0.25. Okay, so M is equal to 0.25 divided by 0.1. He has given in the problem 10 centimeter radius. Okay, means 0.1. So you'll get divided by 0.1, you'll get 2.5 kg. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now we got the angular position. So according to that, you draw the parallel line here. Okay, so what is the direction of this unbalanced force line?
So 1 minute, sir.
Yeah.
We'll take on the diagram.
Okay.
So the distance from 4 to 3 will be 30 mm.
Yeah, 30 mm.
Angle is 210.
Yeah, 210 degree.
Okay.
The angle that I am getting is 276 degrees.
276
degrees.
So what should we do after we get 2.5?
Yeah, we need to find out the couple then. So for that we need to draw the couple polygon. So once you finished, I will tell you how to draw the couple.
Yes, sir, finished.
Finished, huh? Okay. So now we got the
So wait.
Oh. Okay, shall I continue?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So now we need to draw the couple polygon. So for the force polygon, we have considered m into r values. Couple polygon, we need to consider couple values, m, r, l. Okay. So first one, we have the zero at zero position. Okay, we won't bother. Then we have 0.6 at 90 degree and 1.8 at 210 degree. Use some scale for couple polygon.
Can you use the same scale, sir?
No. Use a different scale. One second.
So can we take 0.01?
Yeah, that will become
60 centimeter.
The second one, second become very large.
Then 0.05 only. Then it will be 12 mm.
0.1 it is give 6. 0.05 it will give 12 mm. So this one get, this one will give. Okay, you can use, no problem. One second. Okay, so now observe here, listen here. So we have the value of 0.6 in 90. So first I will use couple polygon. Scale 1 mm is equal to, if I used 0.1, it will become only 6 mm. So if I use 0.5, it will become 12 mm. Okay, 0.5, no problem. Otherwise, you can use 0.0. If I use 2, how much will get? If I use 0.02, if I used 0.02,
second one will be 90 mm.
So you can draw. Otherwise, no problem. 0.05 K. So it is, the unit is kg meter square. This unit is kg meter square. Okay. So now we got this one. So according to that, this value is 12 mm. This value is how much?
37.
Okay. So now this angle is 90 degree. You draw the 12 mm. Okay, vertical line. 90 degree. So this is 0.6. Then we have the position is 210 degree. 210 degree, 36 mm. From this point, you draw. Okay, so this is 1.8. Okay, then you join the line. You join the line from last point to first point. You measure this distance. Okay, you measure this distance of MRL.
So how do we decide the direction?
Not necessary, just
sorry. No, so you put one
this is the opposite direction. Okay, means it will close.
Okay. K. 3.1 centimeter.
So you will get 3.1 centimeter. What is the value you will get? How much point? 3.1 into?
Thirty-one mm into zero point zero.
Thirty-one into 1.55. How much? 1.55. Yes. Okay. M R L is equal to 1.55. So now we know this M R already. Correct? In this previous diagram, right? Previous force polygon, we know this M R. Right, unknown is L only. So L is equal to 1.55 divided by 0.25. Correct?
Yes, sir.
That one you will get 6.2.
Is 6.2 right, sir?
One second. Okay. We can't get that much.
Two point four eight.
You check this value. Have you got this much value? 31 mm.
Yes, sir.
Huh? It is 1.2 and 12 mm. This one is 36 mm. So.
Sir, in the previous, in the force polygon, how did we get the value of radius? Which radius have we taken? Oh, it's given in the question, sir.
Yeah, that is given in the question only.
Okay.
Okay. But I think you check that value. Okay, so you noted down that 31 mm, right? That value?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so actually we have forgotten one step here. Thing is, here I wrote the value of position of A, B, C in the plane. So reference plane is A. From the A, B is 60 centimeter and D, C is 120 centimeter. Correct? In the problem he has given, the radius, the also find the position and magnitude of balancing mass required at 10 centimeter radius in plane L and M, midway between A and B and C. Means L is midway between A and D, M is midway between B and C. Okay, na? So for that one, so here we are going to get, this is L, this is M. Okay, na? This is L plane, this is M plane. So we know that values, it is mid means it is the it is 30 centimeter. This M is from here, it will become 90 centimeter. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
So now, when we are writing here, so one more step in between these two we need to write. That is L. We need to write L here. So the we don't know the mass. So I can write ML. So this value is, what is the radius? It is 0.1. Then it will become 0.1 ML. Then what is the length of this one? 0.3. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Then it will become 0.3 into 0.1. Point 0.03. Okay, so we don't know the angle. We don't know the angle, so we won't bother this about the angle. So similarly, B and C, M, okay, this M, again the val, the length, radius is 0.1, so distance is 0.9, then it will be, this is 0.1, M, this is 0.9, so this will become 0.09 mm. Correct? This is
yes,
M.
Sir.
Okay. So now, so by considering that, we need to find out this couple polygon here. Check. I need to start with here. So I will do one thing. So I need to, I will draw this one. So in next class. Okay. So I hope you got the idea now. So I have left with this value. So we will solve in the next class. Okay, na?
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.